Professor Vithoulkas had also a rich editorial activity. The educational program of the International Academy of Classical Homeopathy has been adopted by various universities. He has a remarkable scientific publishing activity. Many articles and books translated in 23 languages, hosted by well-known libraries, the Library of Congress, the British Library, Harvard University Library, Cambridge University Library, Stanford University Library, the Library of Université Catholique de Louvain, the Karolinska Institute Library, World Health Organization Library, the Berkeley Library, and so on. And now I will present you very briefly the scientific and educational programs which were done in collaboration with our university and the Society for the Study of Neuroprotection, Neuroplasticity. In 2008, Professor Vithoulkas was present at the Second World Congress on Controversies in Neurology in Athens, and he has joint session with Professor Dafin Mureșanu and Professor Vithoulkas. So it was a joint session in 2008 in Athens. Another cooperation with our university was the postgraduate course Introduction on Homeopathy, which was held in Cluj in 2012, between 14 and 20 October. Also, there are some scientific articles, and I will mention conscience and consciousness, a definition in Journal of Medicine and Life in 2014 in collaboration with Professor Dafin Mureșanu. So this was a briefly presentation of Professor Vithoulkas' merits, and I recommend him to university to receive the Doctor Honoris Causa, which is the most important honorary degrees of our university. Thank you very much. Mulțumesc foarte mult.
Universitas Medicinae Pharmaceutice Artium Napocensis Iulius Hatieganu. Nos rector et senatus Universitatis Medicinae Pharmaceutice Artium Napocensis. Damus pro memoria quibus expedit universis quenos consideratis excellentissimus meritis che egregius Dominus George Vithoulkas in docentis discipulis nec non in inquirendis rebus medicinae adeptus est. Facimus, instituimus et ordinamus eundem Dominum verum et legitimum doctor honoris causa universitatis nostre. Prudentissimus, excellentissimus, magister dominus rector, professor doctor Alexandru Irimie.
Dear President of the Senate, dear Vice Rectors, dear Dean of the Medical Faculty, I want to express, before I start my speech, my excitement and my feeling really proud that you have bestowed on me such a great honor. I'm happy not only for myself, but also for this medical school of high standards that honors me and in my name is honoring a healing methodology that I strongly believe that will become eventually a healing process which our humanity is needing today. In 1978, I wrote the main book on homeopathy, which I have written so far, and it was The Science of Homeopathy. This book, fortunately, has become a standard textbook for students in homeopathy. How can I say? My inquiring mind, when I started seeing cases in the 60s, I felt there were quite a lot of links missing in this science that we call homeopathy. So the first thing I felt it was missing, it was a complete definition of health. I felt that students of medicine should know what is health and should be able to define it. And I felt that the definitions until that time did not include the three levels of human being, which is the mental, the emotional, and the physical. So my idea by that time was when I could see people coming out from chronic conditions and becoming happy, balanced, and more structured, I felt that the key word that fitted these patients were freedom. So I felt that a full definition of health should contain freedom from pain on a physical level, with a feeling of well-being, of course, freedom from passions on emotional levels, with a feeling of serenity, and freedom from selfishness on mental level, which would allow a selfless person to become, to come in contact with what we call truth, God, whatever. The main thing for me was that the doctors should understand when they were treating somebody whether they were leading this person towards this freedom. Freedom from pain is one level. Freedom from passions is a deeper level. And freedom from selfishness is a very deep level. I believe I gave an ideal definition, which I think nobody has it in its full sense in our humanity. But it's an ideal, it's a target, which I believe the whole humanity should go towards that goal. Become selfless, really. I believe that the medical institutions that will cooperate in developing this methodology will be the pioneering institution of the new era in medicine. So I want to thank you again for listening, and I want to thank all my friends and Professor Daphin Moresanu, with whom cooperate for the last 10 years. And I am really excited that I'm here with you today, and I'm honored in this way. I want to say a great thank you to all of you, especially those, because I know how difficult it is for somebody who is established and has been trained in a certain way to listen to different ideas. But I believe that through our cooperation, we may open up a new vista, a new era for medicine. Thank you.